Hello everyone, this is the last video we will be discussing for beams. So already in video 5 of module 3 we started discussing a numerical. So this is just, we'll have a glance on this one. So this is the problem asked. So almost we started solving 70% of the problem we have solved. In this video we will be continuing the same problem. So we'll just have a brief recollection. So a cantilever beam, so left side is fixed, right side a point load is acting of rectangular cross section. So since point load is given only on the right side, so only V2 value, so V1 and theta 1 is equal to 0. And first step will be finding out the moment of inertia value for the rectangular cross section. It is 1 by 2 will be h cube. We will be substituting and finding out, and this is a stiffness matrix equation given 2e equal to 0.5 meter, where the formula demands a, so which is 1.5 by 2, so 0.25 meter. I will be substituting in this and we will be finding out this k stiffness matrix and moving to the equilibrium condition. So this one will be getting, and applying the boundary conditions. So since node 1 is fixed, that is V1 theta 1, I will be, by using elimination approach method, I will be eliminating first row first column, second row second column. And moving to this one, at node 2 there is a point load applied towards negative direction. So here F2 I will be showing it as P, and M2 value I do not know, so I will be, time being I will be writing as M2. So ultimately I will be finding out V2 and theta 2. If moment value is given means write that value, if not given means write as 0 for solving sake. So the reduced stiffness matrix becomes, I mean after eliminating the previous things, so what will be left out? 3.974 into 10 power 6, 3 minus 0.75 minus 0.75 0.25 V2 theta 2, and P value, the magnitude value, see, the magnitude value minus 100, and a moment is not given, so it is 0. So after simplifying this one, I will be getting V2 and theta 2 as minus 3.3548 into 10 power minus 4 meter, and theta 2 is nothing but minus 1.0064 into 10 power minus 3 radians. Remember, whenever we are finding out the slope by using this particular formula, always the unit of the slope will be getting in radians. It is not in degrees, so you need not do any kind of conversions for the units, because the formula was framed in such a way that when we solve any numericals in beams, beam numericals, always we will be getting the slope unit as radians we will be getting. So this is the value, and the same continuation of this thing. If we want to find out the deflection, the rotation to the midpoint of the beam structures in the same previous case, means how to find out. So that we will be discussing in this slide. It is not so tough, just concentrate on this particular thing. So always whenever you are finding out the midpoint deflection of any given beam structure, see that this is the given beam structure. What they asked us to find out means, they asked us to find out what is the deflection is happening at the midpoint. That is the thing they are asking us to find out. For that we are taking shape function equation. So the shape function equation for this condition, it is 1 by 2, 1 by 16, 1 by 2 minus 1 by 16. A well known thing, we know that. So zeta which tends from minus 1 to plus 1. So the origin will be 0. And the vector for the midpoint I will be finding out. So first two, V1 theta 1 0 0, I know what is V2 theta 2, that I will be writing here. And this is all the simplified values of the shape function equations which we already discussed in the previous videos. So if you substitute in the previous videos for like the equations, means we will be getting this thing. So we will be getting us minus 1.048 into 10 power minus 4 meter. For the V case, similarly for the theta, like how we have written for V, for theta it is dV by dx. So dN by dx, again the formula, we will be writing same thing. This remains same. for node 1, node 2, this remains same. Only the shape function equation will be varying. So, if you, I told you, I think, hope you remember, when if you have watched the previous videos, I very clearly told you. So, most of the beam problems, they ask us to find out even the deflection at the midpoint or at a distance of so-and-so point, they would have asked. So, if you need to solve, that one means it is mandatory to remember the shape function equations for both vertical deflection and slope, I told you. So, see, this is a perfect example for that one. So, since we solved it very clearly in the previous videos, now it is very easy for us, so that directly I have written the values instead of writing the equations once again and substituting and all the things I have not done. Since I know it very clearly, I have substituted it as it is and only the answers have got it. So, this is how we need to solve this one. Mostly, you will not get any doubts for solving this problem. Still, if you get any doubts to solve this problem, feel free to ask. Thank you.